This a one and nails positive one. Top blogger, top YouTube channel. No matter we sports here, we got it covered. Subscribe and hit the notification bell.
What's up, my wonderful peeps? Sports to the bone here again, man. Shout out to all the viewers, subscribers, and the followers. Big up on yourself. Alright, my viewers, so for today's video, I want to see if I can put together a starting 11 that could compete against Pakistan in the first test. Zane, no, one and two surprises might be in there, but I guess this is just me wanting to try something new. In the back of my head, I sort of know the team that they are going to go with, the safe team, but I just want to go out there, put out an 11 that I think could work, or, you know, what could be an option. So just bear with me, my viewers and subscribers, and then you don't know, as per usual, at the end of the video, you're going to give me your starting 11 that you would use. All right? And I mean, it's not like the performances are so good that the team would pick itself. You know, so you can tinker with it a little bit. So I am going to see how much I can give you a starting 11 that could probably kick off the series against Pakistan. So starting off, we have Craig Brathwaite. Now, this home series here is going to be one that presents Craig Brathwaite with the good opportunity to show that he is still class and he's still capable of cutting it at the top of the order, and he's still the man for the job. Got a half century in the best versus best. I know you can't read into that too much, but would have been a good opportunity to get some work in. So Brathwaite will definitely be at the top there, and partnering him will be Powell. Right? Once again, Powell gets the opportunity to go out there and show that, you know, he's the right man. He's a left-handed batsman, so, you know, that is already in his favor once he's getting some runs on the board. And he will be the man to partner up with Captain Craig Brathwaite at the top there. You know, we saw him against South Africa. Didn't look too bad, facing a couple of deliveries. But, you know, he got out the same way how we have come to know Powell getting out. You know, getting himself in a very unorthodox position and getting trapped LBW. So he will definitely need to work on that. But I am backing him in this 11 here. And he will definitely work with Captain Zane. Alright, at the number 3 slot, we have Nkrumah Banner / Brooks. Right? Now, coming back from injury, Banner will get a chance to show that he's still the man for the job. And, you know, he got a half century in that best versus best game. And Sabina Park is his home ground. So, you know, it would be a good opportunity for him to go back in and to get some runs and cement back himself in. While on the other hand, you cannot turn a blind eye to that century that Shamar Brooks got in that best versus best game. You know, he was the only man that got a century. They were playing against each other. Yes, you might say it wasn't any outstanding bowling, but he was the only batsman that managed to get a century, and a big century at that. So that might play in his favor. But I think I'm going to go with Nkrumah Banner for the first test here. Maybe give him the 2 innings in the first test. If anything, we can draw for Shamar Brooks. Then, next in line, we have Kyle Myers. Well, his runs have definitely dried up, but I'm thinking they will give him this series, especially because of him, you know, being able to contribute with the ball. You know, see, got a couple of wickets in that series against South Africa, so that might work in his favor. Now, it's a possibility that he might make the team, you know, based on bowling. So they could maybe play one less bowler and use him, and then play an extra batsman. I'm not sure how they would work it, but I would go with Kyle Myers, you know, because of his ability to work the bar when it gets old. So when the bar gets a little older, and, you know, Roach and Seals and those guys are not getting much out of it, you know, Myers, with his ability to swing the ball, might get some wickets for us. So he's there also, you know. So boy, I tell you, this team is definitely, boy, I don't know. All right, we also have Blackwood, yeah man, or Raston Chase. We might use Rasta and Chase in that slot. And the batting order don't necessarily have to work like this in my view. So Rasta and Chase, very good technique, might be the answer for those pace bowlers that Pakistan will present to us with the swinging ball and all of that. And I mean, it is only if they don't pepper us with sharp ball, because when it comes on to facing sharp ball, I think all our batsmen, you know, are expected to have problem with those. You know, maybe only Jason Holler is a very good puller off the ball. Jermaine Black would not usually run from it either, you know, but, you know, more often than not, going after it, him usually gets out. So, Rastan Chase might be the man there. We also have coming in after Jermaine Blackwood, another batsman that, you know, will definitely need to use this home series. His country, Jamaica, the man come from, so he need to use this opportunity to go out there, play comfortable, play confident, get some runs under his belt and show that here what? It is not because of this vice-captain position why I'm in the team. You understand? So, he need to go out there and convert him scores. Too often, him getting at the 30s and 40s. And, you know, every now and again, he might get a half century and convert it. So, if he gets a start, he will definitely need to go on and see if he can convert that start into a big score for the team. So, he will be there also. Right? And after Jermaine Blackwood, we have, you know, the experiment that I had indicated to guys, Shea Hope. Yeah, man, I will be using Shea Hope. As I said, you know, the batting lineup might not work like this, but I would be using Shea Hope this time around. Give him an opportunity to be in the starting 11, but not at the top of the order. His glove work is good, so maybe I would play him over Da Silva. It's not like I'm throwing away Da Silva, you know, just resting Da Silva for now. And try Shea Hope in this series. You know, give him these two games, batting down the order and see how things would work. You know, it's not like his technique is not good, because we see how good he is in ODI. But it's a different format. For whatever reason, he's not able to adapt. So we'll put him down the order. You know, ask him to do some wicket keeping and to score some runs down the order and see how it works for him. It might work or it might not work. This, as I said, this is 11 that I am tinkering with, and you know, you guys can give me yours. We also have Jason Holler. Yeah, man, Jason Holler coming in. You know, he's our top all-rounder. Will be expected to slot in and help out with the middle order, get some runs. And then you will be expected to bowl a good quarter of overs, support the likes of Azhari, Joseph Roach, and the other pace bowler that I will be putting in this team. So Jason Holler will come in and we will ask him to do some work with the bat. About time him step up and start get some centuries in. Azhari Joseph is also there. And, you know, he fancies himself as a all-rounder these days. So you will need to go out there, you know, score some runs at the back end of the innings for us, as he has been doing for a little while now. And really, with Shannon Gabriel out of the team, now is a perfect opportunity for Azhari Joseph to go and to prove that he is the best man to partner up with Kemar Roach in the test team right now, Zain. So I'm working with Azhari Joseph. Kemar Roach. Our leader, when it comes on to the test team and pace bowling, he will be opening the bowling for us. So Kemar Roach is there, and he will try to use all his skill to set up the team for victory when it comes on to ball in hand. So Roach is there, my viewers and subscribers. Rounding things off, we have Jaden Seals. Yeah, man, the young pace bowler did very well against South Africa. Will be coming in and will be asked to partner up with Azhari Joseph, Kemar Roach, and Jason Holder in my team to see if they can restrict the Pakistan batsmen. Will be a lot of work. Babar Azam, all of those guys that they have in the team, you know, they are going to be looking to score some runs. So, you know, those are the bowlers that I would have selected to try and keep them quiet. And when it comes on to the batting now, those are the guys that I think I would use in a first test, right? As I said at the beginning of the video, guys, doesn't necessarily mean that this is what I want or this is what is going to happen. Just means that this is a 11 that I would experiment with. I would try something with. you know, the lights of Rakim Cornwall and Alzar and Da Silva and a couple more might feel outdone and feel like they should be in this team. But at the end of the day, as me say, me just an experiment. Zin, so you don't know my viewers and subscribers, go ahead in the comment section and let me know what sort of starting 11 you guys would use. Sports to the bone, keeping you informed. Please remember to like and share. And if you have not yet subscribed, please subscribe to the channel. Big up on yourself, guys. I'm out.